Welcome to our final video of week 5, seawater, where we are going to talk about how and why we see salinity and temperature varying in different parts of the globe. And more specifically, we're going to look at place to place, so we're going to look at different locations, we're going to look at different seasons, so different times of the year, and then we're going to look at how we see things changing on the surface, with meltwater, streams, latitude, ocean currents, and then we're going to look at deeper ocean variation, so how things change as we get deeper in the ocean, higher density. And what we're going to be using is the Geo Atlas program, which you have access to on the course site in the additional resources section, and it looks something like this. So we're looking at the Earth from space, and here we've got kind of the generic how it starts out. You can look at cloud cover only, you can look at ice cover, ocean, continents. You can see the main oceans labeled here. But what I want to do, we're going to look at the hydrosphere. We've got streams and ice, you can look at those, ocean currents, which is next week's topic, and then seawater, salinity, temperature, and then tides, which we'll do in a few weeks. So if we look at temperature first, click on that, we can see how the temperature is different in different parts of the globe. And so here we've got the zeros, the blues, cool temperatures, the reds, warmer temperatures, and you can see how right around the equator, warmer temperatures, poles, cooler temperatures. And one thing to notice here, on the east coast of Africa and South America, we see this kind of loop or a protrusion of cool water moving to the north. And the reason for that is these ocean currents that we're going to talk about next week. So we have this overall movement and transmission of this heat and cool water, hot and cold, from north and south latitudes. So we can move the warm water from the equator to the poles through these ocean currents. So we see warm temperatures around the equator, cool temperatures towards the pole, so warmer water. We have more evaporation, so we can should expect to see slightly higher salinities there. Then we get towards the poles, depending on what type, what season it is, you might see lower salinity levels, especially at these mid-latitudes where we get lots of rain. So that's our temperature. And if we look at salinity here, we go, and I can click on this and get some actual numbers. So again, blue colors are lower temperature, or sorry, lower salinities. Reds are higher salinities. And you can see that our higher salinities do tend to trend around the equator, where we have evaporation. So a few other areas that we have high salinities are places like the Red Sea and the Mediterranean. So 37 or 38, I believe, is what that other one is. So pretty high salinities. And the reason for that is these are closed bodies of water. They don't get to mix with the ocean. They're in kind of tropical locations, warmer temperatures, so we have lots of evaporation. So we're pulling the water out, leaving the salts behind, causing them to be higher salinities. And again, same thing over here in these parts of the ocean, lots of evaporation, pulling that water out, leaving those salts behind. Places where we have lower salinity, so polar regions where we have melting, this is average over a whole year, melting of our poles, we can see 34 around the polar regions down and on the South Pole, and then really low salinities around 30 around India. And one of the reasons for this is during monsoon season, lots and lots and lots and lots of fresh water flowing out of these rivers because there's tons and tons of rain falling on the land surface, which is pretty cool. So we can see freshwater rivers, same thing over in the northwest and a little bit on the east coast too. Lots of freshwater, which means we have our salinity going down. And also around here you can see We've got a little blip here around South America. We have lots of fresh water that can flow out here as well. So overall, we've got fresh water affecting the salinity of the oceans in certain spots, and seasonally, during monsoon season, more fresh water. When monsoon season isn't occurring, we don't have as much fresh water, so our salinity will go up in those regions. And then places that are isolated, like the Mediterranean and the Red Sea, we can get pretty high salinities in those areas because we have lots of evaporation leaving those salts where they are. So that's our overview of salinity, how it changes in time and seasons as well. So we'll come back next week and talk about ocean currents. So hopefully, and now you know what seawater is, some of the major properties, how they change with depth, how they change with location around the globe. You can play around with that GeoAtlas program on your own and see how things change. And then when we change the composition of seawater, change the salinity, change the temperature, we can see how the density is altered as well. And then now you know how we collect and analyze seawater. So I'll see you in lab this week, where we're going to play around with some saline solutions. So I will see you in lab.